There's been many, many conversations about Grant Cardone. Recently, some of his businesses have laid people off. All the haters have come out with videos. Meet Kevin's been riding Grant's the longest. I want you to think about something. If you took every one of these people that are hating on Grant Cardone and put them in a room, then you took Grant Cardone and put him in another room, Grant would have more money than all of these combined haters together by himself. This video was brought to you by HustlersKungFuLifeSkills.com, where we have many courses to help you start your business. And recently, all courses have been repriced to make them more affordable to help you out in these hard times. Go to HustlersKungFuLifeSkills.com, links are below, and pick out the courses that can help you begin to design the life that you want. One of the things that I understand that many of the Grant Cardone haters and critics are not business owners, because there's this statement that resonates so well with me. Those who hate on you are always gonna be doing less than you're doing. And that is just such a pivotal thing, because there are many people who get really close, because there's this thing that's called a social para relationship, where people who watch you on YouTube feel that they know you better than they really do. They actually feel that you have some kind of relationship. And I think this is the problem with Meet Kevin. One of the things that has happened, because with Meet Kevin, who puts out a lot of good information, but one of the things is Grant has had several successful businesses for years, and you tried to put together a construction company and stuff, and that literally folded within a year. You know, Grant's resume is documented. You could go to his YouTube channel and watch some of his earlier videos. You can go ahead and see that the reason that he wrote 10X was because of the last recession. That's why he wrote 10X. That's why he started moving and doing these things to create a different pattern, a different mindset, a different way of doing business, because he got in a little trouble last time and he said, I'm not going to go through that again. In 2017, I had a consulting business and I had a staff of 12 people. The consulting business was very profitable. I was making $200,000 a month, but I didn't enjoy it. It took a lot out of me. I was working 80, 90 hours a week and I didn't enjoy it. So once my last consulting contract was up, I did not renew and I did not get any more clients. So I shut it down. And one of the hardest things in the world is to look someone in the eye and say, you don't have a job no more. That is a really tough decision. It hurts you. I didn't sleep the night before I had to do it, but I did it because it was one of the first things that many of you non-business owners don't understand, who are quick to hate on Grant. The people who have stood in his shoes are not the ones who are talking the smack. They're not the ones making all of these assumptions, because with this great recession soon to turn into a depression, there are many people that feel that the fat rich companies should keep people on and just pay them regardless if they're working or not. And that's just not going to fly, because your first goal as a business owner is to protect the asset, and the asset is the business. If you're a business owner and you've got someone who's underperforming and not doing a good job, you're doing them a disservice to keep them on. And this isn't the case with the people who work for Grant. Many of you just simply don't understand the decision making that goes with owning a business. And that's why people are all over this. He laid off people, he's got a jet. You know, it's crazy. It's really, really crazy. Anytime you create and you do more than someone else, there's gonna be haters. And this is what Grant is dealing with, because they're like rubbing their hands. They're like, yeah, he's failing. He's in trouble. He's going to go out of business. Let me be clear. Let me be distinct. Grant Cardone is not going out of business. Grant Cardone has entered into a territory where he cannot become unrich. See, there's a certain financial level that once you reach this level, I don't care what you do, unless you just develop, even if you develop a massive crack or cocaine habit, you're just not going to become unrich. Grant Cardone is in that territory. He owns a $50 million plane outright. He is good. But once again, you have all of these distractors, all of these haters who have never run a business, who've never been the the man and the woman to make those critical hard decisions. And they're just sitting there because they would really trade places with Grant Cardone in a heartbeat. They would love to be Grant, living the lifestyle, traveling around the country, flying around in the private jet, having a gorgeous family. They would love that. But they cannot understand that this is the way the world is set up. We have winners and we have losers. And Grant Cardone is a winner. I started this business in 2009 in the middle of a recession. One of the things that's going to become very, very clear in the coming months is who's a real operator and who's a pretender. There are many people out there who are seriously over leveraged. There's much discussions about Grant's leverage of properties, but Grant raised a lot of capital. Will there be some people in his properties who are gonna lose their jobs and not be able to pay their rent? Absolutely, it's gonna happen. But the majority of the people who have these properties, who are living in his properties, they're gonna pay their rent because the majority of people are gonna keep their jobs and they're gonna continue to pay their rent. But we will have a category of people who are gonna hit hard times, and that's just facts. And this is something that I'm sure Grant is sitting on a lot of cash. Here's one thing, this is something else, because once again, Grant, I think he started his YouTube channel 2 years before I did. And I can go back to his earlier videos, and something he said, when he was making money, when he had a job, he stashed cash. So I know he's sitting on some ample reserves for the betterment of the company, because here's the thing, how many of you have had a business in a recession and came on there out on the other side better for it? Seriously, how many of you have done that? Because many of the folks who are going after Grant are young, and they've only had this 12-year bull market to reflect on, and they don't know about hardship. They don't know about struggle. They don't know about sacrifice. They don't know about losing stuff. I have a feeling that many of them are about to learn. Instead of hating on Grant Cardone or other people who are more successful than me, yeah, I can actually say that. He's way more successful than me, and I can respect and admire that. What I'm doing, because this is the weekend, and what I'm doing, I'm making videos. I'm putting together coursework. I'm working really hard because I know what happens. Because right now, a lot of people got punched. A lot of people are reeling. A lot of people are trying to figure out what's their next move is gonna be. I already know my next move because in the last recession, I became a millionaire. I became a millionaire in the last recession because I put in the work. Because I understand that hating on people does not put money in my pocket. Many of these distractors, many of these haters, and me, Kevin, this is a message for you, because you had a public failure. You tried to launch these companies, and they crashed because you didn't know what you were doing. And that's okay, because in the game of entrepreneurship, there's wins and losses, and that was a very expensive lesson for you. You hating on Grant, that's not gonna help you become successful. It's good for YouTube, it's good for getting views, it's good for getting AdSense, but that's not gonna help you ultimately be successful. What's gonna help you be successful is to stop hating, put your head down, learn from your mistakes, and go to work. There's so many folks out here who are hoping for someone to fail. In life, I know this is gonna be hard for some of you to hear, because there's this false notion that everyone is equal. And there is nothing further from the truth. There are some people who are better than you. There are some people who are more handsome than you. There are some women who are more beautiful than you. There are people who are richer than you. And that's just the way it is. And a lot of people have a problem with that. And these folks have a problem dealing with reality. Grant Cardone ain't gonna go broke. He's gonna come out here on the other side even richer. Many people right now, and it's really hard to put this in the proper terms, because right now people are very sensitive, because a lot of people are getting hurt. A lot of people are having struggles and stresses that they've never had before. The thing is, in life, there's gonna be battles you win and there's gonna be battles that you lose. One of the reasons that I'm not part of the jealous coalition, because I'm never jealous of anyone more successful than I am. I've had my own wins and losses, and I've had my own level of success. And I know for Grant to be where he is, how hard he worked, how much effort that took, how much money that took, how much sacrifice that took. You don't get to that level without sacrifice. You don't get to that level without accountability. And this is one of the things that so many of these distractors and haters and commentators and people who are jumping on Grant, they love, because see, once again, Grant has been through this before. The question is, how are you gonna do after this recession? How are you gonna do during this recession? I've been meaning to make this video for a minute. I've been wanting to do it because I've been seeing a lot of craziness out here about Grant Cardone, and I wanted to put my opinions, my viewpoints and things out here into the mix, because as a business owner, as someone who has an online business, I understand many of the challenges, and Grant is way more successful than I am, but I've had enough of success in my life where I can appreciate another successful person. I can look at someone who's done more than me with admiration versus being a little hater. And this is where many people are. They're on the hate parade, and it ain't pretty. Let me hip you to something. If you're sitting around hoping someone's gonna fail, then you're programming your subconscious mind for you not to have what you're hoping that this other person who has what you're envious of fails. One of the things I wanna discuss is, right now, it's a hard time for many people. It's a time of uncertainty. People are freaking out. But here's some advice for you. Take this as a moment to figure out what you wanna do with your life. Take this as a moment to read books, take online courses, and study for your next move, because I'm gonna tell you a story that happened to me. I was living like many average Americans, paycheck to paycheck. I didn't have enough money to cover my months. I was struggling. And I was working this temp job at VoiceStream, which now is T-Mobile. And I got laid off, I got let go because I wasn't properly in the proper proximity. I didn't get hired in. I wasn't properly positioned to stay. And they fired me, the top salesman of the month, and let people who didn't have my number stay. And I said, that was never gonna happen to me again. And this is an opportunity for you to go out and build a business. I know there are many people who want to be taken care of. Like the stimulus checks, $3,400, $3,500. I mean, to me, and I live a very good lifestyle. So I'm not even looking for a stimulus check. I'm not even looking for the emergency unemployment for self-employed people. I don't need it because pretty much like Grant, I have serious cash reserves. And if I say that and you feel some kind of way, more than likely you're a loser. And I hate to be so blunt to you, because if someone says they're doing better than you and you get jealous and you feel that they're flexing, because I had someone come in on one of my live streams, well, you know, real rich people don't flex. Bill Gates bought a $660 million yacht. Jeff Bezos bought a $400 million yacht. Rich people do flex. I know that many of you are telling yourself
that rich people are just no different than you. They don't live in better houses. They just have a little bit more money than you.
Stop it, let that go. Because rich people do rich people things. They live in bigger houses, they drive better cars, they enjoy fabulous vacations, and they have hotter wives. This is the reality of being rich. It ain't the same as being poor. And so many people are living the fantasies and these lives of delusion because they want to feel better about themselves. And I'm about to give you some tips on how to feel better about yourself. Go out and do something hard. When you do things hard and you accomplish it and you accomplish these hard goals, your self-esteem, your confidence, it goes through the roof. When I wrote my first book, I was so happy. I was so proud because I started something, I worked on it, and I completed it, and I put it up for sale. This is what's gonna make you happy. Not walking around hating on people. Not walking around wishing someone would fail so you can feel better about yourself. Come on, man. Well, that's my whole piece. That's what I got for you guys. You know, let me know in the comments what you think. But more importantly, watch the next video. I've got a playlist here that's going to be talking about how to get into recession-proof businesses. And this is gonna help you, if you're so inclined, make some better moves so you can have a more prosperous and profitable future. So it should be right here. This should be the playlist. Go ahead and watch it. Check it out.